There are not supposed to be precedents in family law because all children are different and each case should be decided on its individual merits. But the same could be said of criminal law. And just like criminal law, family law has its own set of precedents called court authorities or case laws made by judges usually in the Court of Appeal or High Court. Because of the doctrine of stare decisis, formal justice requires consistency. Therefore, the lower courts must follow the ratio decadendi laid down by the higher court, and judges must respect and follow decisions or court authorities of other judges in the same level court. The Children Act 1989 was intended to make family law more child-centred. However, sometimes case laws build up on the back of an old assumption made in a previous precedent, like a house of cards. For example, the former Master of the Rolls, Lord Donaldson, said in 1992 that the risk of being told by academics hereafter that my views are contrary to well-established authority, I think that there is a rebuttable presumption of fact that the best interests of a baby are best served by being with its mother, and I stress the word baby. But Lord Donaldson was only following an earlier case law made by Sir Rowan Cumming Bruce, who referred to children of tender years. It has also been said that it is not a principle but a matter of observation of human nature in the case of upbringing of children of tender years, that given the normal commitment of a father to support the family, the mother, for practical and emotional reasons, is usually the right person to bring up the children. It might be reasonably expected that an alternative to these case laws made in this country might be legislation from the European Court. Yet according to Merrill's in the development of international law by the European Court of Human Rights, the European Court has adopted a cautious line when interfering in domestic jurisdiction, which takes into account the subsequent practice of the state in the application of the treaty. In layman's terms, although a country may be doing something that is wrong, providing they have been doing it long enough, these infringements may be overlooked. This is a thorny issue, and in the cases of Erschulz versus Germany, the European Court reaffirmed the father's right to a family life, and in Sahin versus Germany took the unusual step of overriding the view of the domestic court, which was that the mother could block contact with the father because she believed that it was in the best interests of the child. Another form of recourse might be through the United Nations Convention on the Rights of the Child. The preamble describes a child's right to family life in the following way. The child, for the full and harmonious development of his or her personality, should grow up in a family environment in an atmosphere of happiness, love and understanding. Article 9 of the Convention goes on to specify the type of care to which the child is entitled. The child who is separated from one or both parents should maintain personal relations and direct contact with both parents on a regular basis. Although there is no simple form of redress through the United Nations, these views are reflected in a new set of guidelines called What the Family Courts Expect from Parents, issued by the Midland Region Family Judges and Magistrates and endorsed by Sir Mark Potter, President of the Family Division. These guidelines state, it is the law that a child has a right to a regular personal contact with both parents unless there is a very good reason to the contrary. Denial of contact is very unusual, and in most cases contact will be frequent and substantial. Nevertheless, UK precedents in family law still tend to discriminate against fathers in relation to their children's upbringing by restricting bonding to an insignificant level in the early years. In 1966, the Law Lords acknowledged that too rigid adherence to a precedent may lead to injustice, and there is a growing number of recent cases in the Court of Appeal in which contact with a father has been maintained despite the wishes of the mother or the feelings of the child. These new court authorities threaten to overturn old assumptions made in previous precedents, like a house of cards.